Hey there, Stampers, and thanks for joining me today. Today, we are going to be creating some elegant beauty with vellum. This incredibly gorgeous card was designed by my downline and friend, Sue McQuiston. She's a really talented demonstrator. Are you dying to see how this is done? Come on, let's get started. We are going to be working with Stampin' Up's vellum cardstock, which is a thicker, gorgeous, beautiful, elegant paper. I'm actually going to be using the scallop oval big shot die. This just needs to cover the oval. It doesn't need to cover the scallops. We won't be using those. Layer that between two cutting pads. Place on your big shot die cut machine and crank it through. Next, we will be taking the Elements of Style stamp set. This is in Stampin' Up! Summer Mini Catalog, and it is gorgeous. Love it. Visit my blog for tons more ideas with it. Using basic black ink, I'll be stamping the 4U stamp on a scrap of vellum, and I'll ink up the big flower stamp. I'm stamping it more towards the right-hand side. Oh, it's so beautiful. Often people will ask me how long it takes for the ink to dry on vellum. It might take an extra 30 seconds, but if you're using Stampin' Up's vellum, it's made to be stamped on, so it will dry fairly quick. We'll be working on the back of this, so you'll want to flip it over. I'm taking the brush tip end of the Certainly Celery Stampin' Write marker and coloring in the leaves. Next, I'll be taking the Regal Rose ink pad and a sponge dauber right on my finger, dipping it in, and on the back of the words, I'm just gonna rub some of the Regal Rose on that and the same on the flowers. And you'll notice when I do this on the flowers, I am going outside the lines a little bit. It's creating a very, very soft, gorgeous effect. And there's a couple places where I'm gonna go in and just press a little bit harder for a little bit darker look. And I'll soften up the edge of that a little bit. Not all of it, though. I want it to have a little bit of dimension. And so you can see what this has done when I flip it over. Isn't it beautiful? It's a very soft, muted effect. Next, I'm going to take the 1-inch circle punch. Punch out those words. I've also punched a 1-inch very vanilla piece that I'm going to layer that vellum wording right on. And we'll layer that on a 1 1/4 circle of chocolate chip. Gorgeous! Next, we are going to be taking a brand new impressions folder made just for Stampin' Up! For the Big Shot machine. This is called Square Lattice, and it is awesome. It really makes a gorgeous textured paper. Slide a panel of very vanilla right inside. Sandwich between two cutting pads, and then place that sandwich on tab 1 of the Big Shot die cut machine and roll it through. Isn't that fabulous? Oh my gosh, I love it. Next, we have creamy caramel ink and a Stampin' sponge, and just rub it right over the top. I left the center because we're gonna cover that. So I attached this with snail. Now, be cautious because adhesive will show through on vellum. So when I flip it over, I am gonna put the snail as much as I can behind the flowers so it doesn't show through as much. We're gonna put that in the center a little bit towards the top. Next, I have some craft taffeta ribbon. We'll attach that with some snail and just tuck these edges under. So I'm gonna do the two loop bow here to make our bow. You kindergarten teachers are either gonna cringe or love me on that one, sorry. And then we'll just tie that and just kind of adjust. And that goes right on the center with either snail or mini glue dots for adhesive on that. Two Stampin' dimensionals on the back of our circle greeting. And then some snail adhesive to attach to your base, and voila! Your card is complete, simple, elegant, and gorgeous. Be sure to visit my blog for the gallery and tons more video tutorials. Thanks for joining me today.